Hey, what's up, y'all? My name is Chris Abbott, but all my friends just call me Abbo. And in this video, we want to specifically talk about chatbots. Now, I know it's a little bit confusing. Some people are a little bit intimidated or a little bit unclear about what a chatbot is. So in this video, we're going to be clearing that up, talking about what a chatbot is, and we'll be specifically diving into how to make a chatbot coming up. Hey, what's up, y'all? Welcome back. Man, if you guys are new to the channel, we put out brand new videos every single day, 5 days a week, helping pastors and church leaders be more effective with digital outreach and social media. So what we want to do in this video is we want to talk about chatbots, right? I personally believe that chatbots are the future of ministry. I've been using chatbots for a little over 2 years now. I've helped over 500 churches in the last 2 years utilize chatbots. And there's a really cool strategy for how you can use this in more of a ministry context, right? So if you do this right, it's not marketing, it's ministry. And I think that's really, really important, right? So what we're going to do is we're going to kind of dive into how to make a chatbot and then how you can use that chatbot in more of a ministry setting in order to attract new visitors to your church. So let's dive in. Now, one of my favorite companies on the face of the planet is Pixar, right? I don't know about you guys. I have two little kids. I love taking my kids to new Pixar and Disney movies, right? And I had a blast reading Creativity Inc., which I think I've read 3 times now, right? So if you're unfamiliar, that's a book that Ed Catmull, the co-founder of Pixar, wrote. It's phenomenal. If you haven't read it, I definitely recommend it, right? But one of the principles that he talks about at Pixar is just this idea of kind of starting before you're ready, right? Taking imperfect action now. So what he says is that most people, when faced with a decision, right? So they come up and say, okay, should we take the hill on the left or should we take the hill on the right? Right? What most people do is they say, okay, well, let's sit back, let's analyze it, let's hire a consultant, let's have a focus group, and let's figure out the advantages and disadvantages of the hill on the left versus the hill on the right. Right? But he said at Pixar, instead of what they do is someone in the back goes, the hill on the left, and they run as fast as they can towards the hill. Now, sometimes they'll get halfway up the hill running as hard as they can, the entire team, and someone will say, wrong hill, and they'll stop, turn around, run back down the hill, and then run up the hill on the right. But he says either way, they always arrive at the summit before everybody else, right? So while everybody else is trying to figure out through focus groups and trying to figure out what they should be doing, they're already at the top of the correct hill. And I think this is a huge leadership principle that we need to understand in the church world, right? So I want to encourage you, chatbots can be intimidating. It might be a little bit crazy, but the best thing that you can do is take imperfect action now, right? Just go dive in, figure it out. And I promise you'll learn more along the way than anyone who's sitting there studying and going through courses and trying to figure it out. You can literally go to manychat.com right now, sign up for an account, right? They have a free account or it's 10 bucks for the pro account. And then you can literally start building a chatbot right now. So you can click on the link in the description below, go over and set up a ManyChat account. Okay, so when I first started using chatbots for churches, right, one of the first things we did is we had this idea that we could use chatbots in order to pray for people in the city, right? We just thought, man, I bet if we just created a Facebook ad that said, hey, how can we pray for you? And then we ran it into Facebook Messenger and used a chatbot to interact with people, then we could kind of scale it, and then we could also lead them to plan your visit, right? So typically, you would go with a Facebook ad to like a landing page or a plan your visit page where people would plan a visit. But a lot of times you're going to lose people when you go from a Facebook ad to a landing page, right? Because now you got to deal with internet speed times, right? Page load speed times, conversion rates, all that kind of stuff. But if you keep them inside of Facebook, it's instantaneous, right? It's going to go inside a Messenger and then kicks off a chatbot. And so we decided to try it. So I reached out to a friend of mine who was pastoring a brand new church plant, right? And they were running about 150 people. They were only a couple months old. And I just said, hey, I've got this idea. Don't know if it's going to work or not, but there are these new things called chatbots. Here's how I think we could use it for the church. Let's give it a shot. He said, yep, let's do it, man. So the cool thing is we went all in, right? We created the chatbot, we created a Facebook ad and ran them into the chatbot, and a crazy thing happened, right? In 6 weeks, 111 people ended up planning a visit to his church, right? So he ended up having over 900 prayer requests that people submitted who live within driving distance of his church, right? 10 miles of his church, over 900 prayer requests that came in through this chatbot. And then 111 of those people went on to plan a visit and give their name, email, and phone number to schedule an appointment to visit his church on Sunday, right? That's crazy. So at that point, we literally said, okay, man, I think we've caught lightning in a bottle here, right? Like we've tapped into something. We accidentally stumbled upon something. So we've continued to innovate and continue to tweak that and optimize it over the past 24 months. Okay, so now that you know how you can use a chatbot for your church, then let's talk a little bit about how to actually make one. All right, now it's important to understand that a chatbot is just simply a series of automated sequences that are delivered inside of Facebook Messenger. Right, so it sounds a little bit intimidating, right? It sounds a little crazy, but it's really just predetermined or pre-written responses that you write ahead of time. So if you have a Facebook ad saying, hey, how can we pray for you? And people click on it, they go into Facebook Messenger, then your welcome message from your chatbot might say something like, hey, we would love to pray for you. Just post your prayer request inside of Messenger. Then the person goes in, they submit their prayer request, right? Maybe they say, hey, man, you know, my wife is having surgery next week. And we're just a little bit nervous about it. So, man, if you could pray for her, that'd be awesome. That chatbot's gonna automatically save that prayer request. And now you can kick off another sequence, right? That might say something like, okay, thanks so much for trusting us with your prayer request, right? We promise to pray for you every single day this week. And then you can kick off another sequence, inviting them to church or inviting them to take a next step. All right, so step number one is to figure out what is your end goal. Right, so for us, what we wanted to do is we wanted to reach as many people as possible, and we wanted to bring in as many prayer requests as possible, and then we had a secondary goal of plan your visits, right? But that wasn't the reason. Like, we weren't doing this to try to get more people in the door. We weren't trying to get butts in seats. What we were trying to do was we were trying to reach as many people for Jesus as possible. We wanted to be a light in the darkness, and we wanted to give them the opportunity to have a pastor praying for them. And we knew that if we did that, some of those people would go on to plan a visit, right? And then some of them would just decide to show up on Sunday anyway. So that's exactly what we did. So when you go in here, figure out exactly what is the end goal of your chatbot first. And again, my recommendation is to have that be a ministry goal instead of an attendance goal. Right? You don't want this to be about bringing people in or butts in seats or plan your visits or just getting a bunch of people inside the church. You want this to be about ministry. It could be prayer. It could be helping people find their purpose or find their calling. It could be, you know, a 21-day marriage challenge or maybe some type of parenting crash course, right? But whatever it is, you want to give away some type of ministry on the front end, and that should be your goal. All right, so number two is determine what is your hook, right? So now that you know what the end goal is, right? So for us, we knew it was going to be, we wanted as many people to respond with their prayer requests as possible, right? Then in number two, you want to figure out what is the ministry hook itself, right? So again, in this case, it was prayer requests, and it was just the opportunity to have a pastor praying for them, right? A lot of people out there, right, just assume that we as pastors have like a direct line to God, right? I don't know about you guys. My family like calls me all the time, and they're just like, hey man, if you could pray for us, we know you have like a direct line to God, right? God listens to your prayers. So if you could pray for your cousin, here's what he's going through, right? Those types of things. And so rather than just try to explain to them how they could be praying to God, right? Let's just kind of play into that. So that is the ministry hook for the prayer request, is just that they could have a pastor praying for them, right? Again, you could create some type of a quiz inside of a chatbot. You could create a challenge. You could deliver a cheat sheet or a crash course, right? But figure out what is the hook gonna be, and then move on to step three. Okay, so before I get to my last couple of points, I wanna hear from you, right? I know chatbots are a little bit weird, a little bit intimidating. So what questions do you have about chatbots? Put them in the comments below. I will read every single one, and I'll do my best to answer everything that I can. Also wanna know, is there something that I'm leaving off or some interesting, unique ways that you've used chatbots at your church? Put it in the comments below. I wanna hear about it. All right, step number three, whiteboard the entire chatbot. Now, this may not be a huge chatbot, but what you want to do is you want to make sure to write all of the responses beforehand before you ever open up ManyChat or any type of software to actually build the chatbot. I do this every single time I create a new bot. I literally go through, right? We figure out exactly what the end goal is going to be. We figure out what the hook is. And then we go in front of a giant whiteboard and we write out every single one. And I literally write out word for word exactly how I want to word each one of the responses, right? And then I point an arrow to the next box. So sometimes you might actually ask somebody a question. Like you might want to say, hey, we're having church this Sunday at 10 o'clock. Man, can you make it, right? And then you could have a button that says yes. And if they click yes, it's going to go over here and deliver this response. And if they click no, it's going to go down here and deliver this response, right? So you want to create that entire map beforehand on a whiteboard. Again, it's not going to be that complicated. And you want to write out everything word for word exactly how you'd like those sequences. Okay, step four, now that you've whiteboarded your entire chatbot, you know exactly what you want to say. Now it's time to actually build it. And I promise, if you take time to do steps one, two, and three, it's gonna be way easier to actually build the chatbot. Otherwise, it's gonna take you a really, really long time. But if you don't open up ManyChat until it's time to actually build it, you're gonna fly through this process. right? So you'll go to ManyChat. Now, they've got plenty of tutorials that are going to show you exactly how to set up a chatbot. And you can also set up notifications to get notified whenever someone submits a prayer request or signs up for plan your visit. So now that you have built your chatbot, right, before we actually release it into the wild and we start sending people to it, now what we want to do is we want to actually test it first, right? So there's a little preview button in there. You can click preview. You can actually test it out on your phone, and you can make sure that it delivers all of the correct responses, that it's working right, right? You just want to test it, make sure everything is working correctly before you move on to step six. And finally, here is the exciting time. Now it's time to start sending people to your chatbot. There's a lot of different ways you can do this. You can do this with email, right? You can do this with social media. My personal favorite way is to use Facebook ads, right? So you can literally just target every single person who lives within driving distance of your church, right? 10, 15 miles, depending on the size of your city. And you can literally just say, hey, Tulsa, how can I pray for you this week? Right? Then when they click on the ad, it goes into Facebook Messenger and automatically kicks off all of the automated sequences of your chatbot. And this is a phenomenal way to be able to build relationship equity and leadership equity with people inside of your city. And then you can invite them to church on Sunday. All right, so if you like this video, hopefully you found it valuable. I tried to take everything that I've learned over the last couple of years with chatbots and jam it all into one video so that you have everything you need in order to go start creating chatbots and using them for ministry in your church. But if you'd like a little bit more help, or maybe you just want to purchase one of the templates we've already created so you don't have to kind of figure it out, then simply go over to churchgrowthagency.com or click on the link in the description below, and we'll see you soon.